And now, it's time to sit back and enjoy the Two True Freaks Internet Radio Broadcast.
Fox Kids is what?
Fox Kids is Zeo powered up!
Everybody, and welcome to episode 116 of Ranger Chronicles. I am your host, Charlie Niemeyer, and today we are returning once again to the bygone era of 1996 to watch two more episodes of Power Rangers Zeo, Invasion of the Ranger Snatcher, and Graduation Blues. So without further ado, let's jump into our first episode. I've got the DVD all set up. You can either watch it on the Power Rangers Zeo DVD set, the giant helmet collection of all the Power Rangers shows, or Netflix. So, without further ado, we're going to get this kickstarted here. I keep saying kickstarted. We're not doing a kickstarter here. All right. We are going to start in 3, 2, 1, go. Invasion of the Ranger Snatchers first aired on May 9th, 1996. It's the ninth episode of Power Rangers Zeo, written by Giles Wheeler and directed by Isaac Florentine. Oh, look at that. It's a movie.
What now?
He blocked my punch.
And your point being?
He can't block my punch. He's just an alien. I'm a star.
What? Are you all right?
I would love to know if the guy playing the director is actually Isaac Florentine.
I trained at the Royal Academy. I can't work with this.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Is that supposed to be his real mustache?
There he is.
Oh, they're on set.
Invasion of Blueface. I can't believe we are extras in a Biff Star movie.
I hate to break it to you guys, but he doesn't look like much of a superhero to me.
Do I detect the slightest hint of jealousy?
Maybe.
Give me a break. This acting stuff is easy. I could do it with my eyes closed.
Watch out! Watch out! I think you need to keep your eyes open so you don't get hurt.
That was not one of your better acting times there. Of course, they're keeping an eye on things.
Remember, men, the head of security is a friend of mine, so be sure you make a good impression.
You can count on us, sir, to serve and protect. That's why we're here.
Good. Carry on.
Man, I gotta find a way to be in that movie. Just think of it. I could be
fighting. Well, that door's not even real. I love it.
Star. Or you could get us in big trouble, just like Eugene Skulovich.
Yeah, that's true.
Is that food free?
Their badges look like stickers.
Talk about your rank, amateurs. Your first film will be bigger and better than they could ever dream.
Really? I mean, of course. Let me see. Wow, they are some really cool monsters. My movie won't be any good without good monsters. Clank, I want those monsters.
Sire, the monsters?
You heard me.
What about the Power Rangers?
Video Vulture will capture them.
say the name of the episode, get a prize.
Guys, I'm telling you, I could be a much more believable action hero than this Biff Star guy.
But unfortunately, you're an extra, remember?
True.
Yeah, but if I could just get close enough for them to realize my potential.
Rocky.
His acting is not very good in this episode.
Came up with this workout program. Looks like he can work.
Isn't it kind of easy, though?
Well, only at the beginning. Towards the end of the workout, you'll both reach your maximum endurance and strength levels.
Well, hey, I'm game if you are. Just give it a shot.
I'll monitor your energy. Sounds like something Billy would do. I would imagine he did that back in the day, too.
Guys, pace yourselves and follow the routine.
How do they know what the routine is, though? I wonder if it's weird for Tommy to be kicking someone wearing green. Dang.
Well, Billy, how was that?
Okay.
Man, this Biff guy is brutal.
You better watch out, Rocky. Hey, you.
Me?
Yeah, you.
Uh-oh.
You talking to me?
How tall are you?
I'm 5'10".
Perfect. Biff's sidekick just got a job on a soap. He's out. Oh. Do you think you can handle it?
He's now Biff's sidekick?
What, are you kidding? Yeah, sure. Of course.
Yeah, no problem.
I'm already falling behind schedule. I've got to have my monsters and you haven't delivered them to me, Clank.
You need to know how to act, though. They didn't ask for that part.
Temperamental directors. My gears can't take the stress. I'm going to have a mechanical breakdown.
No banana for dessert.
Nice little trick.
Hey, nice costumes. Very convincing.
Yeah, but please wear your IDs so we know who you are. A secure set is a safe set.
Come on, you guys are needed on the set.
Good afternoon, Miss Assistant Director. Want a little banana? Huh?
Trust me, kid. I know what I'm doing. Now, you'll be great. When I say action, say a line, and then exit where I showed you. Great costumes. Get them ready for the next shot.
Right.
Sir, I think that there's something you should
know. Kid, we don't have time to talk about your motivation.
But, you don't understand.
Okay, are you ready? I'm gonna pick it up right where we left off.
Now what's he gonna do?
Go on. Go on!
I'll handle this, kid.
Wait.
Uh-oh. Oh, he's a terrible actor. Oh, that's not gonna go well.
I don't think so.
Hey, kid, that was great.
This is not in the script. Those are costumes. Somebody stop them.
Now they can run?
Hey, Kat, Tanya, come on!
Of all the people.
Gotta morph. Let's do it.
That's just gotta be one of the funniest ones yet. Whoa.
Talk about your cast of thousands. Zorna, something really strange is going on. We're gonna need help.
Fast.
Please, sirs, everyone.
This
places.
Is perfect.
Oh, thank you.
Now, let's get that camera rolling and put some great stuff in the can.
By the way, this is taking footage from the actual O-Ranger movie. Rich Sprocket is crazy.
Stolen some movie costumes and lured the other Rangers away from town.
Zordon, I'm gonna teleport back to the power chamber. I think there's more to this.
Now, Billy still looks like he's got the blue on his... It could be the black. Looks like he's got blue on his, communicator.
Hey guys, what's Sprocket up to this time?
I don't know, but he sure brought a lot of help.
Here we go. This is the big fight scene at the end of the movie. This is probably the best fight scene you'll see. Well, at least, well, I don't know. I can't say that. Gotta love the music, though. Wow. Cool move. Battle Zord? This is weird.
Yeah, I think so. Good. Where are we? I have no idea. What is this place?
Power Rangers, your attention.
Try stepping off the thing and see what happens.
Your dreams are about to come true thanks to me, of course. You have been given starring roles in Prince Rocket's latest movie extravaganza.
Not interested.
I'm afraid you don't have a choice.
We'll see about that.
Let's get out of here.
Yeah.
And that's what happened.
Let me try.
Oh yeah, because you can do it better. Oh, good job, Tommy. Look what you did.
You created a disturbance in the production audio track.
What is this movie anyway?
Invasion of the Ranger Snatchers. Catchy title, don't you think?
Maybe if you hit the force field again, it will knock it back in sync.
I'll try.
Okay, that worked.
Man, we gotta get out of here.
Tommy, why don't you hit it with your Zeo laser pistol?
It's worth a try. Everybody,
yeah.
Stand back.
That didn't work.
Try, Rangers.
He didn't even use his, put his finger in the trigger.
This time, Prince Sprocket is writing the script and he demands complete creative control. Now,
there's a door there.
We'll call you to the set when we're ready.
To get through to the Rangers yet?
No, Alpha. That force field's blocking anything visible or audible from getting through. I'm afraid they're trapped.
You must do your best, Billy. Your friends are in great danger as long as they remain in Prince Sprocket's backlot.
I know, Zordon.
How did they know he's in there?
His type of movie doesn't usually have a happy ending.
I'm sorry. How did they know he... How does he know they're in there?
Sense of reality. On my mark. Roll down.
Out of here. If only we could use this phone to call Zordon. Hello? Hello? Well, it was worth a shot at least.
Yeah. You know, I no. thought phones like this were cool. Whoa!
What?
Did you see that?
Yeah. Man, everything's topsy-turvy here.
Man, this is too weird.
Zeo Rangers 2 and 5, report to the set.
Ready for your debut, Tanya?
Well, I guess so.
Maybe we should go with you.
For right now, it's safer to play by Sprocket's rules.
Okay, we'll keep trying to get through to Billy and Zordon for help.
Right. Good luck, you guys.
Let's go.
As in, okay. They're just gonna sit around and wait.
With any luck, we'll all be out of here soon. Be careful.
Well, you ready?
As I'll ever be.
Let's do it. Tanya, stay close.
A flower for the lady?
This is a weird episode. But they have done a lot better of making it make sense. The actual movie was rough.
signal to Sprocket's closed circuit frequency. Hopefully this will work.
Billy, it seems to have worked. We're receiving a transmission now.
I can't believe we're stuck here like this.
Guys, can you hear me?
Billy?
He's on the TV.
Oh, man, fantastic. How'd you do it?
Modern technology, I guess. Are you guys all right?
Well, we will be as soon as we put an end to Sprocket's low-budget disaster.
And the sooner the better.
Zordon, I've been thinking about something that you said earlier.
Yes, Billy?
You said movies like Sprocket's don't have happy endings. Well, what if the Rangers change that?
By significantly altering the course of his movie, the Rangers might be able to recover their powers.
Then that's exactly what we'll
do. They don't have their powers?
Okay. Looks like it's time for a rewrite.
They didn't tell us that before.
Live happily ever after.
Right, and in the meantime, I'll try to contact him also.
Thanks, Billy.
Good job, man. Come on. Oh, guys, here goes nothing.
The door opened differently last time, didn't it? Didn't it?
Hey guys, we talked to Billy and he figured out that...
Yeah, I know. And I think we found our opportunity for a happy ending. We just have to stop that bus.
Oh no, it's out of control! Those people are gonna get hurt!
We have to hurry!
But how are we gonna get there? Whoa! The chickens! They must be coming through a passageway from the movie world. If they can come this way, we should be able to go back the same way. Let's give it a shot, guys.
You know what would be great is if there was like a sound effect for like the pipe from Mario. Horse riding.
You know, I've always wanted to say that.
I told you this was weird, right? I want you to realize too that a lot of this is actually Sentai footage. How are they all getting in there? They were kids they saved. At least in the original.
You alright?
How about you? You okay?
Not so much now. Huh, fake people.
They just disappeared.
Don't you see? We did it, guys. We changed the end of the movie.
We're back to reality.
All the ingredients for a happy ending. Yes! Yeah! I only hope Prince Sprocket is done with his less than brilliant film career.
A happy ending? That wasn't my directorial vision. That bus was supposed to go off the cliff with the Power Rangers in it.
Excuse me, sire. I know how disappointed you must be. I've taken the liberty of working up some new storyboards of my own. I have a feeling this ending is more of what you had in mind.
Frank, that's a brilliant solution. That's exactly what I wanted.
I don't know if you know, the storyboards take a long time to put together. What the heck?
Looks like you could use another bat!
Well, one monster we haven't seen before. Oh.
Ugly and big in just a minute. Around and away. Goodbye, Rangers.
Jeez. Go! Looks like a train more than anything else. The way they made it, the way it looked like it was, this monster was a combination of all four of those monsters. But weird. Any day now, guys. What? It's not too often you see the Megazord making that, purposely making destruction like that. Of any season.
Show business world can be so cruel.
Yes, but there is a dark side to all of this. The movie bug is out of his system.
I like that. There is a dark side to all of this.
Thanks, Tanya. Gosh, I wish Tommy and the guys were here to see this.
I know, but you know they have to practice. I mean, Billy's got him on a tight schedule.
Rocket! We're shooting the climax with the alien first.
Great, where do you want me?
Oh, no, you don't have to do that. We have a stand-in to do it for you.
Oh, skull.
Excellent.
Wow, I love showbiz.
Oh, that was actually pretty good. However, Rocky's acting is terrible in this episode. I love the bloopers. Anyway. All right, that's going to do it for this episode, so we're going to take a quick break, and then when I come back, we'll watch our second episode, Graduation Blues. See you in a second.
What could possibly be bigger than winning a truckload of Power Ranger toys? Winning the truck they come in, too. Now get zapped by Zeo and the most Zeorific Fox Kids sweepstakes ever.
Power Ranger Zeo!
You could win a Ford Ranger filled with all the new Power Ranger Zeo toys and more.
Pretty cool, huh?
300 others will win an all-new Power Ranger Zeonizer toy.
Zeonizer, power up!
To enter, get us a postcard by May 3rd with your name and address to Fox Kids Zeo Truckload, P.O. Box 230, Los Angeles 90078.
Let's do it!
All right, and we're back. And we're ready for our second episode, so let's get things started. I've got the DVD queued. Netflix, hopefully, if you're watching it through that, is ready to go. And I'm going to get us started in 3, 2, 1, go! Graduation Blues was the 10th episode of Power Rangers Zeo. It first aired on May 4th, 1996, written by Mark Lighton, and directed by Isaac Florentine. Hey, we actually get to see...
You wanted to see me, Mr. Kaplan?
We actually get to see Kaplan's office.
I reviewed your academic records and caught an alarming mistake.
I don't understand. I've always had exemplary grades.
Oh, no. Your grades are very good, Billy.
Is this the last time we see
Kaplan? It's not your mistake, it's ours.
Sir?
Well, I'm afraid there's been a computer error. Apparently, you've taken more credit hours than any other student at Angel Grove High and maintained a 4.0 GPA.
Is that bad?
Bad? Billy, You've exceeded Angel Grove High's requirements. You've graduated.
But whoa. I still have another year.
Not anymore. Congratulations.
Wait a minute. He took an extra year worth of classes? Oh, this is ironic because he would be using sticks similar to that samurai. Good job, Bulk.
I'll be back within the hour. Make me proud.
Gentlemen, is how we rid the garbage of the police academy picnic. Make me proud. Yeah.
Tut tut.
Skull. This is how we pick up trash.
Oh, you're using this trick again.
Yes, sir. We're on the job.
Oh, look at this. Now they're back.
Well, that'd make us proud.
We'd be proud to make you proud, sir. Just give us a couple of trash poker thingies and step aside.
Ooh. What is this? Angel Crow doesn't have earthquakes, except when it does.
Come on! Where'd everybody go? Hey, wait for me! Dang, do I still get to use this trash poker stick thing?
Shut up and follow the humans.
Ugh. That looks horrendous.
No. No, I'm not cleaning that up.
What if somebody's inside that thing?
No.
If we save them, we'll be heroes.
Yeah.
Come on.
No.
Well, that worked. Oh, water!
Great idea, Skull.
Oh, he got it worse than you did, Bulk. Sestro! Why didn't he just teleport? He doesn't remember him?
Don't be scared. Reassure him, Skull.
Yeah, they don't bite.
Hey.
Much.
Their hair's dry.
Please. I am Sestro Aquitar, and I must find a human named Billy. The fate of the world depends on it.
Whose alien spacecraft is that?
It appears to be one of those dreadful creatures from Aquitar. He has some nerve landing on Earth without a royal authorization.
Perhaps we can turn this to our advantage. What are those Power Rangers now?
Ghostbuster at a party, Dad! I feel a plan brewing!
Thanks. Thanks. I can't believe you guys organized this so quickly.
Wow.
Yeah, you know,
this is a quick party.
To graduate.
I think it's really terrific, Billy. So what are you going to do with all your spare time?
Well, I haven't had much time to think about it. It happened so fast, you know? Skull. Skull? 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 Is there something I can help you with?
Bulky! I got him!
That's the only Billy we know.
Yes, this is the correct Billy.
Sestro?
Wow, they did their job. I mean, not very well, but they did it.
Your great intelligence is normal, Aquitar. Our planet is in terrible trouble.
Bulk, Skull, listen, I appreciate your help, but I think I can handle it from here.
Don't mention it!
Ouch. Uh-oh, Sestro's just learned something.
Hey, Bulk, you think anybody's gonna bother the spaceship?
Nah, it's well guarded.
Oh, no.
No. Pick the trash up. Guard the spaceship. I can't take it.
Ah, my large golden friend. At least we have a home.
Monsters. Must be part of some invasion force.
Another one.
They're not taking over this planet on my watch.
You do get... No. Any shots? Yeah!
Oh, this doesn't work any better than last time.
Stop! You're under arrest!
Uh-oh.
Billy, a race of fearsome creatures known as the Hydrocontaminators are at war with Aquitar. Thousands of them are poisoning the waters of our planet.
They have caused our main computer system to shut down. We cannot power our battle boards. We can't even teleport.
That would explain that.
I came by starship.
Well, you know the Power Rangers are ready to help at any time.
We have been trying to develop a weapon capable of destroying the Hydrocontaminator, but our prototype is unreliable. We need your help.
Look, you know I'll do whatever I can to help.
And we must hurry. Intergalactic travel from your galaxy to ours is unpredictable and dangerous. There is a window of less than 2 hours to pass through the space portal safely.
Aye, aye, aye. Oh no, and now there's trouble!
Another spacecraft has landed at the lake!
Ah, oh, no, quiet the pollution! I'll start with this lake!
Let me guess, a Hydrocontaminator.
Affirmative. It must have been sent to stop me from my mission. If unchecked, the Hydrocontaminator will destroy the Earth's entire water supply.
Alpha, contact the Rangers.
Right away!
And see, Billy would have made a great Zordon type guy.
Still in my ship.
Well, then we better get there before the Hydrocontaminator does.
I think we lost him!
Well, Zordon and Alpha should be able to teleport them to the... Oh, never mind. Maybe not. Oh, come on! Goldar was still running around the thing!
Hey, stop! Come back here! I said you're under arrest!
Right. And they don't see them running off. Okay. You know, I have to admit, based on what I've seen from Space Shuttle and other space vehicles, they did a good job of making it look like it did travel through space and have to deal with the whole, you know, atmospheric disturbances and everything.
This is the prototype?
It will, as they say, require some assembly.
Uh-oh.
Your worthless weapon will never make the trip back to Aquitar. Is it true that humans are mostly water? Let's find out as I contaminate you.
Ah, there we go.
Stop right there, Hydrocontaminator.
What is
there we go. Heroes.
Everyone appears to be frantic and I haven't done a single thing yet.
Who is that creature?
It seems very unfriendly.
Good. Let's help it then. Send down the cogs. They'll protect it from those costumed commoners. I'll contaminate every drop of blood. Who are you?
Cogs.
What are they doing here?
Now, this is cool, but think about the cog fight they had last episode. And now this is going to take them a while to deal with, like, one or two each.
It'll destroy the Earth's water, and I will be to blame.
We gotta get this back to the power chamber and fix it. Otherwise, the Power Rangers don't stand a chance. Alpha, can you teleport us back to the power chamber?
You got it, Billy.
Hurry up. Ooh. Oh. Man, they're doing good this time. Well, yeah, just stand there, Adam. Oh. What are they gonna do? Well, the lake's been contaminated before. It's there we go. Oh, it's Tommy, so of course he can do it. Oh, good, knocked him towards the lake. Now they're doing it. Inspired, I guess.
Hey, this is no time for a swim! Not exactly waterproof, was he? Now, where'd the others go?
The cogs are gone. In a
it's time for you to leave too.
Oh, I'll leave all right. Just as soon as I contaminate your precious water supply, and then I'll just the place to do it.
He disappeared.
Uh-oh.
We've got to find out where he went before he has time to do any damage.
Right.
Come on, guys. Let's teleport to the power chamber. Now.
Meanwhile, something's up. Of course.
Vaultfire Stolovich, front and center.
Yes, sir.
Sir, sir.
Gentlemen, we are under alien attack.
Really? What do they look like?
Like a monkey in gold armor and a bunch of badly stacked bones. Gentlemen,
this is funny.
It's up to the three of us to stop this menace. Are you with me?
Sir, yes, sir.
Don't worry, Lieutenant. We'll track down these aliens for you.
Hey, they're waving back. Good luck tracking down those aliens, sirs.
That's good. Ooh, what's this?
Ah, the city's water treatment plant. The perfect place to start. Zestro will have to halt his work to stop me. Now, where's the water? I'm so agitated, I'm fading out.
Oh, that's something
water
important.
Has to be around here somewhere.
Huh? Hey, man, you looking for water? Just get rid of the power wrenches and I'll take you to all the water you could ever want.
He may have just stopped him from committing the pollution.
Hey, it couldn't have been helped, sister.
All we have to do is find the monster and stop it.
Yeah, but if we can't fix this weapon, it won't be that easy.
And we have to make sure that Sestro blasts off before he misses his launch window.
Alpha, have you located the hydro contaminator?
Yes, the monster is outside Angel Grove's water treatment plant.
I must go. No, Sestro. Billy needs your help. We'll take care of this.
Back to action! Steel Razor! Steel power weapon! Now!
Oh, is this where they use the cannon? I sure hope so. Now look at this! I love it when they do this on the Sentai. It's like bigger fight scenes. Same thing happened a lot in the first season of Mighty Morphin. Like the first time they fought Scorpina during the Green with Evil. Detroit?
I'm going to find the power source of your weapon to work in conjunction with the Power Rangers' own individual weapons. If it works, we should have a Zeo
Blaster. He's got the toy versions. There's so little.
It'll need some additional modifications to work on Aquitar, but it should prove effective here. I hope.
I am unsure if I can make those modifications myself.
I know. That's why I've decided to go back with you.
Whoa.
Billy, that would be a sacrifice far beyond what we would ever ask.
Look, you and the other Equitians do the same for us, Sestro. I can't turn my back on you now.
The Rangers of both worlds are lucky to have you in their lives.
Thanks.
Don't mention it.
Oh no.
His contact fell out.
My contacts.
I actually saw them.
I'll help you, Billy. It's no problem. I'll find them.
Alpha.
No, he's blind now.
Fixing the Zeo Blaster now.
He can shoot blasts from the star? That's cool. I did not know that.
Oh man, I wish the Zeo Blaster was ready.
They... Billy was just saying that they would do that. How did they know that's coming?
Well, I'm glad I had my old glasses laying around.
It is ready.
Of course.
Just in time, the Rangers will be pleased.
Alpha, it's in its teleportation case. Go ahead and transport.
Transporting Zeal Blaster to the Rangers now. I hope it works.
Billy, the launch window is diminishing. We must act quickly.
Sestro is right, Billy. You have done everything in your power to help your friends.
I guess you're right, Zordon. I just feel weird leaving him.
Here's Floofy. Oh, here we go. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but the Zeo Blaster's made out of their weapons. The ones they were just using. So how did they have to get sent to them?
I can't believe I trusted that alien to do my work.
Do not fret, my mechanical monarch. Next time, stick to your own machine.
Yes. Next time will be much better for us, my dear Queen Machina.
Then we will crush those paltry Power Rangers forever!
Oh, look, they speak in unison. Isn't that cute?
Are you sure you want to do
Guess you got new contacts.
I've dreamed of an opportunity like this since I was a boy. I can't pass it up. Besides, my parents gave me their permission.
He got permission from his parents to go to another planet?
Okay, Sestro.
How do you explain that?
I'm ready.
Without the whole... by the way, I'm a Power Ranger. I used to be one. Bye-bye, Billy. Huh, he's got a scuba gear. And his chemistry book. Not sure why, but okay. If he thinks he's got to do a lot of swim, why take a book? It's just going to get messed up in the water. Note the brown tape on the book, too. Bye, Billy. Not terrible special effect there. Oh, they were just a minute too late.
Look, there it is. Hey, Alpha, are you sure this is where it is?
Yes, Tommy, I'm positive.
Hey, look, do you see the scorched earth?
Hey, look over here.
Guys, I think we're too late.
They didn't notice that before? Now with this, that means all of the original five Power Rangers are gone. Now Billy will come back, but as of right now, the original five are gone. Oh, look, an animal cookie. Good thing the cup was... Ha ha ha. I love bloopers. Alright, but that's going to do it for now. So we're down a whole ranger? Well, I guess we're not technically down a ranger because he wasn't actually a ranger. But how are they going to continue without, you know, Billy's hard work and everything? Anyway, so that's it for the first 10 episodes of Zeo. So I will be back next time with two more episodes of Power Rangers Zeo, A Few Bad Seeds, and Instrument of Destruction. So be ready for that, and I will see you next time. Bye, everybody.
Thank you for listening to Ranger Chronicles. Feedback for the show can be sent to prchronicles@gmail.com
or feel free to leave a comment at the show's posting at PowerRangerChronicles.com. All images and music heard on the show are copyright their respective holders and are meant to help celebrate the Power Rangers. No infringement is intended. Power Rangers is copyright Hasbro Entertainment. This show is dedicated to all the men and women, both in front of the camera and behind the scenes, who have worked to bring us Power Rangers for over 25 years. Ranger Chronicles is a proud member of the Two True Freaks Internet Radio Network. Please be sure to stop by twotruefreaks.com to check out more great shows. Thanks again for listening, and good night.